Hello students, welcome to the online teaching learning process of subject mobile application development. So we are in the second unit. Today we will see the last topic of this unit, that is Dalvik virtual machine. This part is not elaborated or explained in detail in any textbook or any reference book. This part we are covering additionally. So the basic syllabus of second unit consists of only three main topics: 2.1, 2.2, and 2.3. This part, as this is a very important part, and this question may be asked in MSBT exam. So we are studying this topic, that is Dalvik virtual machine. Course outcome of this unit includes install and configure Android development and environment tools. The learning outcome of this video includes to study and to introduce the functioning of Dalvik virtual machine. Also, we will study about the different advantages and disadvantages of Dalvik virtual machine. POs mapped are PO1, PO4, PO6 and PO7. So coming to the topic, that is Dalvik virtual machine. As we all know, when we use Java, we used to use Java virtual machine. Now what is the Java virtual machine? It converts the Java compiler, converts the Java code into the machine code, which is understandable by the processor or the machine. Now this machine code is additionally converted into the byte code by Java virtual machine. So the functioning of Java virtual machine is to convert that machine code or the Java code into Java bytecode. So why we convert it into the bytecode? Because it is understood by any platform which is used by computer system. That's why Java is a platform independent language. Java programs can be run on any platform, on Windows, on Linux, or any other operating system. So that part was in Java. The similar type of functionality in Android is provided by Dalvik virtual machine. So the Dalvik virtual machine or DVM is an Android virtual machine optimized for mobile devices. So it is specially, DVM is specialized or is specially used for developing mobile devices application. It optimizes the virtual machine for memory. Optimization means what? The best use of our resources. That means optimization. What are the different resources we have got? The most important resource is our memory, along with the hardware and the softwares, the efficiency and the battery life. So it optimizes the virtual machine for memory, battery life is the most important aspect in case of mobile devices, and the performance of mobile device. Dalvik is the name of a town in Iceland. Iceland is a country in Europe. So Dalvik is the name of a small town in Iceland. The Dalvik virtual machine was written by Dan Bornstein. So this is the basic introduction why it is called as Dalvik and who introduced Dalvik virtual machine. The DEX compiler, like the Java compiler, in Android we use the DEX compiler. The DEX compiler converts the class files into the .dex file that runs on Java, that runs on Dalvik virtual machine. So it is 95% similar to the Java virtual machine. Java virtual machine also does the same task, it converts the Java class file into a .java file. Similarly, the DEX compiler converts the class file into .dex file that will run on the Alvik virtual machine. The multiple class files are converted into one .dex file. So now let's see the compiling and the packaging process from the source file. So here we have given two different scenarios. One is of Java and one is of Android. That is, one is of JVM and second one is of DVM. So the left part of this diagram shows the functioning of JVM. So Java virtual machine, it gets the Java source code, converts it into Java bytecode, and the Java virtual machine will convert it into bytecode. Okay, now the Java bytecode, which is converted by Java virtual machine, is used by DVM. In mobile devices, the Java bytecode is used by DVM. It converts it into Dalvik bytecode. What does the DVM do? It converts the bytecode converted by Java virtual machine into Dalvik bytecode. And this bytecode is given to the Dalvik virtual machine. Now this Dalvik virtual machine will convert this Dalvik bytecode into the .apk file, that is our application file, that will be run on mobile devices which are using Android. So this is the comparative study of two virtual machines. So both virtual machines are used in mobile devices, JVM as well as DVM. What will JVM do? It will convert the Java class file into Java bytecode, and then comes out our DVM, which will convert the Java bytecode into Dalvik bytecode, and then it is given to DVM, which will again convert it into .apk file. So this is the self-explanatory diagram in which the .java files or the source code is converted by Java compiler, Java C, into the class file. Now the DEX compiler will get that class files, get it into a single file, that is .dex file, package it with the help of .apt, that is an extension of packaging, and convert it into .apk file. So the Java files will converted by Java compiler or compiler into class file. Class file will be converted into bytecode by Java virtual machine. This bytecode is taken by DEX compiler, which will convert it into Dalvik bytecode, and then the Dalvik bytecode will be processed by Dalvik virtual machine into the .apk file. Now coming to AAPT, the AAPT is what? AAPT is the Android Assets Packaging Tool. It handles the packaging process. Now coming to the advantages, what are the main advantages? So it supports the Android operating system only. DVM supports only Android operating system. Executable file is .apk. Execution is faster from Android 2.2 SDK. Dalvik has its own just-in-time compiler. So from version 2.2 of Android, SDK provides a inbuilt JIT compiler. DVM has been designed so that a device can run multiple instances of virtual machine effectively. Applications are given their own instances. So these are the major advantages of Dalvik virtual machine. Applications are given their own instances means multiple applications have their multiple instances. So it helps in the multi-programming or multitasking. Coming to the disadvantages, it supports only Android, so it cannot be used on other mobile operating systems. For DVM, very few retools are available. Retools means reassembly tools, requires more instruction than register machines to implement the same high level code. So the requirement of instructions are very much more. App installation takes more time due to DEX. The installation of any app on your mobile takes much more time than that on Apple mobile. Why this is performed? Because the Java virtual machine converts it a Java class files into a .dex file. So the multiple files are converted into a single .dex file. That's why the app installation is somewhat slower in Android mobiles as compared to the iOS operating system, which is used by Apple. More internal storage is required. So the important MSBT questions are: explain the DVM in detail and state the advantages and disadvantages of Dalvik virtual machine. So we have learned today about the Dalvik virtual machine and its advantages and disadvantages. So thanks for watching the video. In the next video, we will start our third unit. Before that, there will be class test on second unit. So we will start our third unit, that is user layouts, in which we have to study the different layouts. From third unit, we are basically starting the development of our customized mobile app. That is how we can develop the mobile app by using Android Studio.